slowly tilt your chin back to your center line. And then inhale, arms sweep high to the side. Exhale, flip your palms and press and exhale energy out and away from you. Fingertips move all the way down to 10 feet on the hips. And then inhale, arms sweep high. Exhale, flip and press. One more time. Inhale. Spins back behind you. Turn and look out past that shoulder. So gauge your twist in terms of how you're feeling in your spine. Crown of the head lifts a little bit higher as you take your eyes into the side of the skull a little bit more. Exhale. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, slowly move yourself through your center line. Same thing on the opposite side. Right hand to left knee, left hand spins back. Fingertips facing your glutes. You're going to press up through your chest and hold here. Big inhale. Breathe all the way into the top of the chest, base of the throat. Exhale. Two more big breaths. Big inhale. Press into the palms. One more time. Big inhale. And then exhale and start to just kind of windshield wipe your knees back and forth, side to side, just creating some movement in your hips. And then slowly let your legs drop over to the right hand side. Heel toe your right foot out from underneath your left. And then just drape your ankle on the top of your thigh. Press. And think about releasing the outside of that left hip. Big inhale. Exhale. Two more big breaths. Big inhale. Exhale. One more time. Big inhale. Exhale. Pull your knees back to your center with your ankles still stacked or draped over that knee. You're going to press into your palms and ground down through your foot and lift your hips up. And slowly drop it down. Keep going for four. For three. For two. And one. Hold at the top. Big inhale. Exhale. Flex through the foot a little bit, maybe create a little bit of pressure and pull down through your knee. And then release. And release that foot. Windshield wiper your knees back and forth, side to side again. And let your knees drape over that opposite side. Heel toe your left foot up. Ankle drapes. Hold here as you press into your palms. Raise up through your heart and chest. Hold here. Allow the outside of that right hip to open as you continue to draw breath in towards your heart. Big inhale here. Exhale. One more time. Big inhale. Exhale slowly. Swing your knees back to your center. You can readjust that ankle across your knee. Readjust through your hands. Press up through the heart and chest. Big inhale here. And then slowly inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Two more. Inhale, lift. Exhale down. One more time. Inhale, lift. Exhale down. And slowly release. Windshield over your feet, back and forth, side to side again. And then go ahead and bring yourself all the way down onto your back. We'll just do a little bit of ab work before we start to flow, everybody. So all the way down to your back. Let's go ahead and take the soles of the feet high to the sky first. Pull down through your low belly. Then flex your toes back towards your face. Like you're trying to cross the ceiling away from the big inhale here. This is a great space where you can take your hands into your low belly and kind of massage out. You can find your psoas, right? So that big muscle that's usually like super, I'll speak on my body, super tight, right? So that muscle that runs from your pelvis all the way up to your hip bone. But it's a nice space. Even if you go out for a massage, most likely they're not digging around in your abdomen, so give yourself permission to kind of move your organs, your low belly, and everything around, creating some space there. Helps you with your digestive system. And then slowly flexing through the feet, let the legs come out into a big V here. Still pressing, right, the ceiling away. Hands can be there for support. Try to keep the low back down to the earth. So keep pulling down through your lower abdomen. Maybe point and flex through the feet a little bit, maybe do some rolls with the ankles, moving one way and then the other way. Just paying attention to where there might be any sticking. Big inhale here. And exhale. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale, you're gonna pull the legs back to the center line and you're gonna cross your right leg over the left. And then you're gonna point your toes like you could hook them back behind your left calf. And then your arms are going to come around into eagle arms. So your right arm is going to come underneath your left arm. And then the arms cross up by the biceps. You're going to hook right by your elbow. So pull the arms back together, the forearms back together. And then your thumbs are towards the face and pinkies are towards the sky. On your inhale, lengthen through the body and try to tuck your fingers back behind your head. And then your heels move towards the end of the mat. Squeeze the inside of the thighs. And then you squeeze the elbows and knees together and touch. Inhale out. Exhale, squeeze. We go for 8, for 7, for 6, for 5, for 4, last 3, last 2, and 1. Squeeze and hold. Release the arms. Let them come out to the side. Back of the head comes down. And then let the knees still twine around each other. Move over to the right hand side as you pull down through your left shoulder and look up past your left fingertips. Big inhale, breathe into the upper part of your chest. Exhale, hold one more time, big inhale. Then slowly squeeze the legs and move them back through your center line and let them drape over to that opposite side. Turn and look out past your right fingertips, pull out through your right shoulder blade. I'm hoping this one pops your SI joint back into place.
Yeah.
Big inhale. And then exhale, squeeze the thighs and bring yourself back to your center line. Release the legs. Take them high to the sky again. Big inhale. And And then same thing again, let them be out. Here, think about wrapping your muscles around your bones. Right, so deepening that crease between the tops of the thighs and the hips. Big inhale here. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Then exhale, that left leg this time. It's gonna cross over your right. And then left foot hooks behind your right calf. Left arm underneath your right arm. And then hands are gonna scissor back together. Thumbs towards the face, pinky fingers towards the ceiling. Squeeze. And then on your inhale, hands move back behind the head. Heels reach towards the end of the mat. And then squeeze through your center line. We go for 8, 7. Pull out through the low belly. For 6. For 5. For 4. Last 3. 2. And 1. Squeeze and hold. Inhale, arms up. Let the legs move over to the left hand side of the mat. First, turn and look out past your right fingertips. Big inhale. One more time. Big inhale here. Exhale, slowly squeeze the legs and move them through your center line. And let them drop over to that opposite side. Turn and look out past your left fingertips. Keep that left shoulder blade down towards the earth or pull it down. It comes away, that's okay. And then slowly bring the knees back to your center. Squeeze, release the legs. Take them high to the sky. Big inhale here. Then on your exhale, take the hands back behind the knees. And then just do a little bit of rocking and rolling on your spines. And then bring yourself up and over, bringing yourself into a tabletop. So wrists stacked underneath your shoulders, knees are underneath your hips. You can allow yourself just to kind of swish and sway back and forth, side to side. Opening up through your hips, pulling in on your low belly. So finding whatever movement is calling to you. Maybe you take your knees a little bit wider. Maybe you pull them closer together. Right. So checking in with the step of the hips and the femur bones. Are things in alignment, falling into place? You're the one who knows your body best. Okay. So listening to it as you move. Moving in one direction, make sure that you switch it up, balance it out on your own count. And then allow yourself just to come into some stillness in your tabletop. Plant down through your palms. And then on your next inhale, heart and chest, move forward towards the front of the room. Drop your low belly down into cow and press down through the tops of the feet and shins. And then exhale, pull up and in on your low belly as you press into your palms, round into your calf. And then inhale, match your breath to movement. Heart and chest, move forward. Breathe low, exhale. Pull up and in on the low belly, press into your palms. Two more, inhale, heart and chest, move forward. Exhale, press and pull. Inhale, bring yourself back into your table. Tuck your toes, and then send your hips back and high, down dog. Hello, through your heels. Check in here, nice deep inhale. If there's anyone that does not want to be adjusted or touched in today's class, can you go ahead and just kick a leg to the sky for me? And I will respect your space. So doing that full body scan, hands are nice and wide. And then think about turning your elbows with the hands staying in place. Eye of the elbow looks away from you. The point of the elbow looks back at you. Hips continue to move back and high, then you pull down through your heels. Nice deep inhale. Exhale. Two more big breaths. Nice deep inhale.
belly still engaged, right? Protecting low back and sacrum. Shake your head, yes.
Shake your head, no. Maybe draw some circles.
With the crown of the head.
On the floor underneath you.
On your next inhale, hands move up the front part of the feet and shins. Flat back. Exhale, down and over the tops of the thighs. And then on the next inhale, sweep yourself high to the sky. Exhale, tent, crack it open. Inhale again, breathe from the base of the belly all the way up to the base of the throat. Exhale. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale, close it up. Hands move down to your sides. All right, everyone. Inhale, arms sweep high. Exhale, dive down and over the tops of the thighs. Inhale, hands to shins, flat back. Exhale, palms plant, step, step, back into your plank. Nice deep inhale. Fire up through the hands. Think about wrapping your muscles around the bones with the arms. Press back through the heels. And then we're just going to drop one knee down and then the other. So stretching out through the back part of the calves. We go for 8, 7, 6, 5. Last 4, 3, 2. And one, nice deep inhale. Exhale, drop down to the knees, tops of the feet, foot flat, lower all the way down to the chest and belly. Hands stay right next to the bust line. Maybe you lift one leg and then the other. Pull the elbows in close to you. And inhale, baby cobra. Pull the elbows in close to the side body. Take the shoulders away from the ears. Big inhale here. Breathe into the base of the belly. Press down through the tops of the feet. Again, big inhale. Exhale, release. Tuck the toes. Press to your knees. And then send your hips back and high, down dog. Pedal it out. Check in with your hands. Check in with your hips. Check in with your elbows. And then slowly tiptoe your feet back up to meet your hands, top of the mat. Inhale, hands to shins, flat back. Exhale, down and over. And then inhale, sweep yourself out. Breathe into the belly, exhale. Inhale out. Exhale. One more time, inhale out. Exhale. Close it up. Hands move down to the sides. Stop all. Run through one more side. Find that full extension. Exhale. Dive down over the tops of the thighs. Inhale, hands to shins, flat back. Exhale, palms plant. Step, step, back into your plank. Big inhale. This time you're going to move slow. Right knee to right elbow. Step it back, but press back through that heel once the foot hits the mat again. We go for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Big inhale. Exhale, drop down to the knees, toes flip flat, lower all the way down to chest and belly again. Just warming up the spine. Strengthening through the abdomen, baby cobra, hold here. Exhale. Press down through your pelvis. Roll back and down through your shoulders. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, lower. Press to the knees. Send the hips back into a child's pose here for a quick moment. Curl your fingertips out in front of you. Allow yourself to breathe. Child's pose can be as active or as passive as if you didn't like it to be. So whenever you inhale, you always have the opportunity.
option of crawling your fingertips out in front of you. On your exhale,
simultaneously, and send the hips back and high. Whatever feels best in terms of how you come into down dog. Regardless of how you choose to move your feet in that one, think about pulling back and up through your low belly. So it's the strength of your abdomen that drives your hips back. Big inhale. And then exhale slowly. Take that right leg high to the sky. Big inhale here. Exhale, hold. One more time. Big inhale, lift. Let the lift come from the upper part of the hamstring, the low part of the glute. You try to keep your hips square to the mat. Spot your right thumb and step your right foot up. Tweak your right hand. Drop your back heel. Warrior one. Big inhale. Arms are high. And warrior one, the majority of your weight is on your front foot. Okay, again, checking with your toes so you're not gripping. Big inhale here. And then when you shift into your warrior two, everybody, you open through the hips.
more time. Big inhale here.
Exhale, straighten
the front leg, hinge the hips back as you reach through the right fingertips and hand comes down to shin. Opposite hand comes head of the sky. Triangle pose, big inhale here. Exhale. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, turn your torso parallel right down to the earth and then do a little mini half pop up here. Inhale, lift yourself high. And then on your exhale, bring yourself down into your pyramid pose. Use the fingertips and the hands to reach out in front of you. As you engage your low belly, come into it with a nice flat back. Edges of the fingers hit the mat or the floor in front of you. As you're still shifting back through your right hip and pulling forward with your left. Big inhale. Low belly's engaged here. Hands can always release. You can always tend the fingers to either side of that right foot. Big inhale here. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. And then ground down through both of your feet and engage your legs. Pull yourself up with a nice flat back. Big inhale here. Come onto the ball of that back foot. Put some buoyancy in your legs. And then slowly with control, you can have your blocks close by for balance. You're going to bring yourself down and into your warrior three. Try not to drop heavy into the outside of that right standing hip. Okay, so keep yourself lifted. It's like you're balancing on top of your hip bones. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, put a bend in the front knee and then just let the ball of that left foot drop down. Inhale, hips high. Move slow. Exhale. Take yourself all the way down. Palms are going to plant. Step your right foot back to meet your left. Press back through the heels. Take whatever flow is calling to baby cobra. Full forward facing dog. Big inhale. Wherever you're at with it, breathe into the base of the belly. And then either drop the knees, tuck the toes, or roll over the big toes simultaneously. Send the hips back and high. Down dog. Big inhale. Come back to your breath. Big inhale. Exhale. Right, so to lower your heart rate, keep your breath in and out through your nose. It'll help you regulate how fast it is that you're breathing. To also cool yourself down, you can think about focusing on extending your exhale. Right, that will also help you lower your heart rate. Inhale, left leg high to the sky. Three-legged dog. Big inhale. Be strong here. Check in with your hips. Press into your palms as you continue to move your hips back. Big inhale. Spot your left thumb. Step your left foot up to meet your left hand. Pop that, those right toes out and over, and then drop that back heel and sweep yourself high into that warrior one. Big inhale. Remember, the majority of the weight is on that front standing leg and foot first. Big inhale here. Check in with your back right glute. And then you're going to pivot yourself into your warrior two. Press into both of your feet equally and open yourself up towards the mirror side of the room. Nice job, y'all. Big inhale. Pull through the fingertips. Flip the front palms or whatever's in front of you. Take it back. Big inhale. Once you find that extension in your spine, put a little bit more of a bend in that front knee and move it towards your baby toe. Try not to grip with the feet. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time. Big inhale. Breathe into the base of the belly. Stay with your breath and then pull yourself forward. Hinge your hips back. Reach through the fingertips. Hand comes down to shin. Opposite hand comes side to side. Big inhale here. Exhale. One more time. Big inhale. Exhale. Turn and pivot. And then you're going to do a little mini half hop up your mat. Then inhale, sweep your arms high. Bring them into your prayer pose. Coming into
slowly, with a nice flat back, keep your low belly pulling up and in. Reach through your fingertips and come down and over. Edges of your prayer hands hit the mat or the floor in front of you. And then you can think about tucking your chin in towards your chest and pulling your forehead down to meet your knee to catch a little bit of extra compression if it's what you're seeking. If not, you can always release your hands too and tent them on either side of your foot, or you can always take your hands to your hips just to check in with where it is that you're holding to make sure that your hips are in a nice straight line. And then on your next inhale, engage your low belly and sweep yourself up. Nice flat back, press your palms into one another. Big inhale here. Come onto the ball of that back foot. And then slowly, you're just gonna tip yourself into your warrior three. Remember, blocks are your best friends, okay? So drop down through your hip, big inhale. Exhale, hold. Think about wrapping your muscles around your bones on that standing leg. You're balancing your hip on top of your thigh rather than sinking into it. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, slowly drop the ball of that back foot. Arms sweep high, high crescent lunge. Exhale, come down and over the top of the thigh. Palms plant. Pop your right foot back behind and step your left foot back to meet your right. Press back through your heels, take your flow however you like it. Lowering and lifting. Breathe into the base of the belly. Exhale, roll back and over the toes. Pedal it out here. Nice deep inhale. And exhale. Slowly tiptoe your feet up to meet your hands, top of the mat. Inhale, hands to shins, flat back. Exhale, down and over the tops of the thighs. Inhale, sweep yourself high to the sky. Exhale, tense it open. Inhale, exhale. Sit yourself back down into your chair where we started. Hold here, baby pulses for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold here. Inhale, heart and chest lift. Exhale, hips move back. Inhale, heart and chest lift. Exhale, sit it back. One more time. Inhale, heart and chest lift. Exhale, press into the soles of the feet. Bring yourself up to sit. Hands down to your sides. Grab a sip of water. Back to your breath. And we'll slowly start just to make our way back down to the earth. That's what we're doing. We're doing. Back high. Right leg high to the sky, three-legged dog, big inhale. Spot the outside of your right pinky and step your foot wide. You might take a couple hops to get it up there, okay? I like to say it doesn't matter how you get to the party, just as long as you get there safely, okay? Same way coming out of like your posture too. Doesn't matter how you get home. Just as long as you get there safely. Okay. Nice deep inhale. Let your knee kind of move out to the side and palm down through that left hand. Rock to the outside edge of your foot. It feels good for you to open up to the outside of your ankle. Now take your hand to the inside of your thigh. Press the leg away from you. Nice deep inhale. Breathe into the outside of your hips. One more time. Big inhale. Exhale, take the sole of the foot down to the earth, and you can either come down to blocks or come all the way down to your forearms, whatever feels best. You can also just stay on your palms, right?
checking in with your knee to make sure it's stacked relatively over your ankle, right? And not moving beyond your toes at all. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. And you can either stay on your forearms or you can come to your palms, wherever the reach is for you. But maybe think about putting a bend in your back knee and pulling your heel in towards your glute. And then hand comes around to grab onto the foot. Pull the heel in towards your glute and allow the front part of your quad to let go. Exhale. Stay here with the big inhale, breathe. Exhale. One more time, big inhale, breathe. Exhale, release. Come up onto your palms and heel toe your foot across your mat. As you come to the outside edge of your foot and you drop down into your half pigeon, right? You can keep as much of a bend in your knee as you need to. Okay, making sure, most importantly, that you're not dropping into your hip. Okay, so you can always stack your hip if you need to, or you can always wedge a block in between your belly, the top of your calf, and then bring yourself down and over. Nice deep inhale here. Exhale. Hold here. Breathe into the outside of the hip. Be directive with your breath. You may not have control of your life, but you have control of your spirit. Okay? And your spirit wants you to through your breath. Okay? So directive and guide it in terms of what you needed to do. Send the hips right back into your down dog. Nice deep inhale. Take that left leg high to the sky, three-legged dog. Big inhale here. Spot that left pinky. Step that left foot wide. Maybe it's single hop, maybe it's a double. Pop those right toes out and over and drop down to that back right knee. Palm can plant, and then maybe you rock to the outside of that left foot. Maybe you take the hand to the inside of the thigh. Again, everything's optional. Feel it out in terms of what feels best for you on any given day. Nice deep inhale. Stay with your breath here. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, drop down to the sole of the foot, and then maybe come down to blocks or to your forearms. Again, you can keep yourself on your palms too, whatever feels best for you on any given day, right? One thing I like about like the hot 26 and 2 practice, you know, for folks that haven't taken it, you know, they have the same dialogue that they come back to each and every time. And they always say, you know, different body on any different day. Right? So our bodies change based on the amount of sleep we got the day before, didn't get, what we ate, what we drank, right? And evolution is real, right? So your body is actually changing every single day. Nice deep inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, bring yourself onto your palms. And then again, you're going to heel toe your left foot across your mat. Put as much of a bend in the knee as you need. Check in with that back hip. Make sure you're not landing on one side of your hips or the other. Sit up nice and tall. Breathe into the base of the belly. And then on your exhale, bring yourself down and over. Pull in on the low belly and then pull the crown of your head towards the wall in front of you. Maybe glance back at your foot and that leg. Is it right behind your hip or is it off to the side?
Right, you can make little adjustments. Big inhale. Exhale. Slowly take the palms to the mat. Use your toes to kind of pick your hips up, press into the palms, the hips lift, step that left foot back to meet your right, and send your hips back and high. Pedal out through your heels, press into your palms, big inhale. And then exhale, drop down to your knees. And you can keep your toes tucked. We'll come into one more back bend, and then we'll come down onto our seat and just counter it. So, coming into camel pose, traditionally, sometimes it's nice to always have blocks close to you in this one, just depending on where you're at with your grip. So traditionally, there's a drop back that people do, right? Hands can go to the low part of the hips. You try to come into it with as flat of a spine as you can, and you can reach down to grab your heels. Or you can hold on to the blocks and kind of walk yourself back into it. I personally prefer a tuck on the toes. It also depends on your anatomy and how long your arms are, right? So, hands are going to grab onto your heels. You pop up through your heart and chest, and then press and drive your hips forward. And then you can flatten your feet, untucking your toes, and breathing into the base of the belly. If you start low with the blocks can be here, your toes can be tucked, and then you can drive your hips forward and walk up with your blocks. Right? So, take whatever feels best for you. Once you get into the posture, just breathe all the way deep into the low belly. And then allow your breath to clear out the front side of you. Again, big. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, come out of it the same way that you went in. So if you dropped or press the hips forward, see if you can draw the hips back with the tuck on the toes. And then slowly release. Bring yourself down to your seat. Let's counter it right away with the one-legged forward fold. Sole that right foot inside the left thigh, left foot is extended, inhale, arms high, exhale, down and over, engage your low belly, just imagine in front of your head, hitting the top of your foot, feel the front of your head, hitting the top of the foot, okay, big inhale, exhale, one more time, big inhale. Exhale, slowly walk yourself up. Swap out your feet. Sole of that left foot inside of your right thigh. Turn towards that straight leg. Inhale, arms come high. Exhale, dive down and over the top of the thigh and pull the crown of the head towards the top of the foot. Squeeze the sole of the foot to the inside of the thigh. Pull back through the hip. Pull in on the low belly. Big inhale. And exhale. Two more big breaths. Big inhale. And exhale. Space between your pelvis and your belly button, in towards your spine, and it loops around the backside of your belly. this, hinging at the hips. Flex the toes back towards the face. And you can allow yourself to come down into the posture by lengthening through the arms and then just bending down through your elbows. Right? So it doesn't have to be you really trying to pull through the hips, right? Let other parts of your body help lead you into it, okay? Start with something little rather than just like this whole like shift that happens in your hips. Allow it to start with your fingers. Thank you.
next breath. Perceptions of life are becoming more colorful, and you're opening to different colors and experiences. Color breaks up old black and white thinking and opens our hearts to the beauty of life and love. The colors of the rainbow are variations of white light, reflecting the diverse experiences of life. And they are all valid. Each color of the spectrum has its own energetic vibration that stimulates certain responses and healing. Different colors mirror your current physical, emotional, and spiritual state. And our souls use this mirror to communicate our needs to heal or to embrace balance. Get to know what colors you're attracted to and the ones that repel you. Ask yourself why. You are love and you are loved, no matter how colorful your or another's life is. So as you flow on your breath, allow yourself to go into your heart. And imagine a nebulous of clouds, of color, that shift and move in your own heart space. Allow yourself to glide and kind of ride on each colored cloud, feeling their different qualities. Red, which is our root chakra, is about grounding and strong foundation. Orange, which lives in our low belly, okay, is about creation. Yellow, the space of your lungs and your solar plexus, is where your confidence lives. Green is your heart space that roots you to this earth in a space of healing. Blue is your throat chakra. Allows you to speak your truth in your own self-expression. And then purple is that space, or that violet color is that space that shines from the top and the crown of your skull. That allows you to reach a full mind, heart, soul, and spirit. Time as they need this morning. about 5 minutes past the hour. The divine light, the divine feminine, the divine masculine, the divine love in me sees, honors, and reflects the divine light, the divine feminine, the divine masculine, and the divine love in each of you, the collectively in all of us. Thank you all for sharing. I love it. For sharing your practice with me and trusting me with your bodies, hearts, spirits, and souls. When you leave your mats, be sure to go in peace. And remember to serve love always. Thanks so much, y'all.